Hi all, welcome back to another card making video. I made a card with an all time favorite L'Enfant stamp set, and that is Party Animal. It's a fun and easy card to make where I imagined that the critters organized a surprise party. Let's quickly dive into it. Spreek je Nederlands? Er is ondertiteling beschikbaar. Like I said, I used the Party Animal set and I point out the images I used. If you want a full list of all the supplies, you can check out the blog post in the description. I also used the Holiday Party Animal set just for the raccoon. I made a top fold card base out of craft paper. With the outside in rectangle stackables from L'Enfant, I cut out a fun patterned paper. You could also use the last stitched rectangle stackables for this. I took the colors on the paper as a guide for my color scheme. With the 4-square backdrop landscape that I will use in portrait style, I cut a frame out of colored cardstock following my general color scheme. With the scripty happy die, I cut a happy 2 times out of colored cardstock following my color scheme as well. I glued those together to make it a little thicker. In the stamp set you can find a happy birthday, and I heat embossed only the birthday part on some light blue cardstock with white embossing powder. I stamped, colored and die cut the images off screen. And last but not least, I will use some green glitter to make the card extra special. Now it's time for assembling. Like I said, I colored the images according to the color scheme I picked from the background paper. I used normal critter colors for all the critters. That's what makes them pop off the card, while the color scheme of the accessories really tie them into the card. I messed up the highlight on the deer's head, so I will cover that up with this party hat. I first glue all the accessories to the critters before I start assembling my card. Because I already made this card before I recorded this for a video, I know which accessories go where. But you can always lay everything down first with the help of the frame and take a picture of it before you assemble. This way you can balance everything out. For example, things I did are placing the critters with the tail opposite of each other and gave them something in the paws. I gave the bear and the deer the same party hat, but I made sure they totally differ in color. This distributes the different things all over the card evenly, so it looks really balanced. Now that is done, I'm going to use my Quickie glue pen to add some glitter to the bottom of the scripty happy. I like using this pen for this because it gives you a lot of control and you can easily see where you've put glue because it's blue. Don't worry though, it will dry up transparent. I dip it into some glitter and tap off the excess. Then I leave it to dry while I continue. What I like to do with this kind of scenes is taking the frame and glue everything in place before I adhere it to the card. This makes it way easier to tuck things behind the frame. Like I said earlier, I know where I want to put all the images. If you don't and didn't make a photo earlier, you can still do that to make it easier. When needed, I cut off little bits of the images to make them fit. With frame cards, I like to put images so that they are partially behind the frame, but also parts are in front of the frame. Like the fox who is behind the frame with his feet, but the left side of his body is on top of the frame. For easy assembling, I like to hold one image at a time in place, put a little glue somewhere where I can easily reach so it's stuck in place, and then put glue on other parts where needed. I sometimes check with my sentiment pieces if everything is going to fit, and I continue gluing everything in place like this. Now that everything is glued on, except for the happy, I continue with gluing on the patterned paper background. I put glue all around the rectangle and on the inside parts of the frame and the critters as well. Take your time aligning it so it will look really neat. I'm putting glue tape on the card base with my ATG so I can adhere my scene to the card. I noticed that I have a little bit of card sticking out of the bottom, so I just trimmed it off with my scissors. It's the reason I always start aligning from the fold down, because you will be able to fix these kind of things. Now, the only thing left to do is gluing on the scripty happy. I check if it's in the right spot before I press it down carefully to avoid rubbing off too much glitter. And with that, the card is done. Although the card is flat, I love all the depth it has with the different animals popping from behind the frame. Like I said, it's pretty quick and easy to make this card, and you can easily do this with other patterned papers, colors and images as well. I hope I inspired you with my video and that you feel inspired to get crafty as well. If so, please consider leaving a thumbs up, subscribing to my channel and ringing the bell to receive a notification when a new video is up. Thanks for watching, see you next time, bye!